औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम, आई एम योर सोशल स्टडीज़ टीचर फ्रॉम दार अरकम स्कूल, मदीनातुल हुज्जाज, कोलरा मोड़ कैंपस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज आर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज इन आर लेसन नंबर 2, डेन्यूडेशन, एंड द टॉपिक इज मैस वेस्टिंग एंड एरूजन, इम्पैक्ट ऑफ मैस वेस्टिंग एरूजन एंड कॉजेज ऑफ मैस वेस्टिंग एंड एरूजन। First of all, we discuss about the mass wasting. What is mass wasting? Mass wasting is the downward movement of the large pieces of rocks and debris, soil due to the force of gravity. What is mass wasting? When the downward movement of large pieces of rocks, debris and soil due to the force of gravity is called mass wasting. There are the 3 types of the mass wasting. One is creep, rock fall and rock slide. What is creep? It is the slow downward movement of rock fragment on a weathered slope. When a rock slowly moves downward from a slope, it is called creep. Next is rock fall. What is rock fall? Rock fall is the free movement fall of rock from the mountains or hills. When rock fall downward from the rocks or from the mountains and the hills, this is called rock fall. Next is rock slide. It is a rapid downward flow of bedrock material on a slope. When a rock is quickly moved downward from a slope, it is called the rock slide. The best example of is landsliding. Next one is the causes of mass wasting. Gravity, slope material and water are the causes of mass wasting. There are some other causes of the mass wasting: oversteeping of slopes, removal of vegetation. Let's start with the gravity. What is gravity? The force of gravity pulls rock downward. When gravity pulls the rocks downward, influence of gravity is minimal at gentle slope and maximal at steep slope. Gravity is minimum at the gentle slope but maximum at the steep slope. Next is slope material. What is slope material? The slopes that contain layer of a soft material like clay or shale respond more to mass wasting than hard surface slope. Next one is water. When water as a lubricant for downward movement of rock and debris, water exerts pressure on rocks and reduces friction. Heavy rains are the major condition of water, so that's why it caused the mass wasting. Next one is erosion. What is erosion? It is the process in which rock is worn away and transported by water, wind or ice. The process of removal or wiping away of rock fragment is called the erosion. Erosion is happened due to the mass wasting and weathering. There are different causes of the erosion: wind, soil and the moving ice. What is first one is running water. It is the cause of erosion. The force of running water as rivers gradually washes away rock fragments along the rivers. When water flows along the bank of river, It wash away the rock fragments. This is called the cause of erosion. Next one is moving ice. The force of moving ice as glacier brings the surface of rocks. Glacier take with them debris that leads to the formation of long cuts on the surface called grooves. When glaciers are breaking down, then it always break down the rocks that cause the erosion. Next one is wind. What is wind? Wind erosion is common in desert areas, sand dunes from the desert, when the wind carries away loose particles of sand. Heavy rain cause the erosion. When there is heavy rain and wind, it takes a smaller rock fragment with them. Wind carries or blows sediments and soils from one place to another place. It carries sediments and soils from one place to another place. Soil erosion is caused by the natural processes, water flowing downhill or wind, or because of the human activities, our cropping, our grazing and deforestation. Now, what are the impacts of erosion and mass wasting? The first impact is on agriculture, on irrigation, human settlement and transportation. Agriculture, when floods wear away on the top of the fertile soil of agricultural land, this result in less crop and this destroy the land fertilization. So that's massive mud flows coming downhill and completely destroy the fields of valleys. Next one is irrigation. Dams are built for irrigation purposes and production of electricity. Massive mud flows can completely bury the dams, which result in lack of the irrigation water and decrease the electricity production. Mud flows destroy the irrigational water and decreases the electricity production. Human settlement due to the floods. Due to the floods, human settlements on a large scale is based on the bank of the rivers. So, the settlements which is present on the bank of the rivers will completely destroy with the mud flows or the floods. Transportation, landsliding of glaciers and rocks, blockage the roads and other transportation routes in mountainous area. These are the impact of erosion and mass wasting on our economy and on our life. Agriculture, irrigation, human settlement and transportation. Now, what are the ways of minimize these impact? We can minimize these by planting the more trees and plants which become control the mass wasting and erosion. In hilly areas where slopes are steep, barriers and retaining walls should be built. Steep and dangerous slopes should be removed. Settlements can be increased in those areas. Plant more trees, build barriers and retaining walls in the sloping areas, and dangerous slopes should be removed from those areas. Thank you so much. Your homework is learn the definition of erosion and mass wasting and write it on your notebooks. Thank you so much.